Hey Red Zone Community, I'm here at the Bavarian Coaches Convention and with me is Ted Dasher, former coach in the NFL for the Eagles and Oakland Raiders, for example. Right now coach at the Walsh University.
Yes.
So Ted, nice to have you here. What is your first impression from Europe and Germany so far?
First time I was here, flew into the airport at Frankfurt and got in a car and drove over here. The scenery is beautiful. People have been great, very hospitable. Martin, obviously, who's hosted this event, has made me feel very comfortable. And the coaches, you can tell, they're really into football.
So you mentioned Martin. Was he like your first contact for the BCC over here, or what was your first contact with football in Europe or Germany?
Patrick Yasumi, who I've known from working with me in the NFL, is an associate of Martin's, and I think they got together and called me and asked me if I wanted to do this. Obviously, I do. I want to get around Europe and travel and see as many things as I can, and this gave me an opportunity to do it.
It's good to have you here. So, you mentioned before at your presentation that it's a big difference with punt units like in the NFL, mm-hmm. Division One, Division Two. What is, in your opinion, beside athleticism, the biggest difference between NFL D1, D2, like when it comes to organization and coaching?
I think the most important thing at all levels is teaching the basic fundamentals and techniques, which let guys have some success and confidence. You're always trying to build that, but the scheme aspect, because there's more coaches as you go up in football from Division II to Division I, there's more coaches from Division I to the NFL. The people in the NFL spend 24/7 studying schemes, and therefore it's a little bit more in-depth and detail. And Division I football, it's good quality of football. And it's also in Division II, it's just not as in-depth because the people that you have working with it.
Okay. So would you say, because football is growing here over the last like 5 or 6 years, because the NFL is on free TV right now, would you say that Europe should focus on developing coaches and, like you said, teaching the basics instead of like going into scheme-wise, things like that?
I think this convention is an excellent way to go. There's a good turnout. People are here. They're trying to learn football. I thought all the speakers that I saw did a good job of explaining that and trying to get young people to get involved, have success, and enjoy playing football. I think that's what we're all about, and I'm just glad that I'm here and be a part of it.
Okay. So one question about your topic today. Why does no NFL team basically play a spread punt, or why don't you see that a lot?
The NFL is an entirely different type of athlete. And if you allowed people to run at a shield like the college spread punt, the collisions would be something that you were trying to get away from in college and pro football, not go to. And you just can't do that. You can't let those type of athletes get that much head start running. I think the collisions would be a bit much. And I also think they block a lot of punts because their speed, they're going to get there faster. That's why they have the normal pro spread punt.
All right. So last question. When do you get a returner for your college from Germany? Do you think that is possible?
I have been a proponent for a long time just because I remember, I can't remember his name, the guy that played at Florida State, that played in the NFL.
Björn Werner?
I remember him coming out, and when he came to the U.S., very talented guy. Patrick has told me about guys over the years. At the school I'm at, we're actually trying to recruit a couple of German linemen.
All right.
I think there are people here that have the potential. They're a little bit raw, maybe not quite developed as much as some of the guys in the States, but yet, especially at Division II level and Division III, that those kids could go over, have success. And I think that would help football, obviously, in the States and also here.
So do you think not only the NFL, but also colleges from every level should scout more in Europe?
Absolutely.
Like not only in the youth teams, but also in the German league?
Absolutely. Austria, Germany, all the different countries that have programs. I know their youth leagues are big and their club teams are big. But I think there's guys with potential here. And, I'm hoping to get my eyes on a couple before I head back and go back to the States. I just think there's a lot of potential here, and I hope to see the game grow.
All right. So, Dan, thank you for your time, and it was a pleasure.
All right. Thanks. Thank you.